Recently, I got myself a bit of ferrofluids that is suspended in a clear liquid inside a flask. You can get this practically everywhere on the internet. Now, the special thing about this black ferrofluid goo is that it gets attracted by magnets. So by using the included permanent magnets, we can have a bit of fun with it. And I have to admit that it was fascinating to look at. For around 5 minutes. I get why this product is so popular, but simply using a permanent magnet with it is just too boring for me. So in this video, I will be showing you how I combined this flask with a bit of electromagnet coil winding, soldering, programming, and a tad of 3D printing in order to let my ferrofluid dance according to the bass, middle, and high frequencies of the playback music. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by JLC PCB, which is a PCB manufacturer that I can highly recommend. And today I want to present to you one of their new features, the pre-order parts feature. It allows you to order the SMT components for your boards before doing the SMT assembly PCB order. This way you will not run into the problem that there are not enough components available for your design. But feel free to check out a JLC PCB on your own to learn more. First off, it is pretty obvious that we cannot use permanent magnets to make the ferrofluid dance, because we cannot electrically control them, except maybe with motors. No, instead we need such electromagnets, which you can get from the internet as well. After connecting them to my LabBench power supply and powering them with the voltage which was printed onto their label, I noticed that the small magnet didn't feature a strong enough magnetic field according to my tastes. The big magnet, however, came with a strong enough field, but sadly we cannot use it for this project. The problem is that the big magnet is simply too big for my idea. Which is that I will position 6 magnets behind the flask in this layout. The left ones react to the low frequencies, so the bass. The middle ones react to the middle frequencies, and the right ones to the high frequencies. If there's only a bit of the frequency bands in the music, then only the lower magnets will be on. And if there are a lot of the desired frequencies, then the upper magnets will turn on as well. It is kind of like a color organ, or VU meter, but with magnets. And speaking of color organ, feel free to watch my very first video, which was a color organ, because I will actually be reusing a bit of its circuit design later on. But anyway, while the big electromagnet didn't fit, the small one did perfectly. So how can we make its magnetic field stronger without changing its diameter? To find that out, I took the magnet apart, and as it turns out, it simply consists of a ferromagnetic core with a diameter of 8 mm, and a coil with tons of windings whose enamel copper wire comes with a diameter of 0.18 mm. Now, to increase the strength of a magnet, there are two options. The first one is to increase the applied voltage, and thus the flowing current. But that was certainly not possible with the commercial magnet due to the thin wire, which would have led to a thermal meltdown. So instead, we have to add more windings to the coil, which sadly was once again not possible with the commercial magnets, because the 1.5 cm long coil was already packed full. To solve that problem, I firstly brought in my own 8 mm thick ferromagnetic iron core, from which I cut a small piece for testing. As you can see, it performs perfectly fine with the commercial coil, which means we can use it for my DIY electromagnets. To make them, I first had to design this wire holder core model in Fusion 360, with a length of 3 cm instead of only 1.5. Which I then 3D printed 6 times. Afterwards, I hammered the iron rod piece into the middle of one plastic core and then utilized 0.22mm enamel copper wire to create lots of windings around this core with the help of my electric drill. To determine the perfect amount of loops, I stopped winding from time to time, removed a bit of the varnish from the copper wire with sandpaper, hooked up my lab bench power supply, limited the current to 0.5A, which this wire size can handle, and tested whether I was happy with the magnetic field strength, which I was not yet. So it was time to create more loops. And eventually I hit a sweet spot at around 7V and 470mA, at which point the magnetic field was strong enough for me. And even better, the max temperature the magnet reached that way was around 70 degrees Celsius, so still acceptable. So I continued this project by cutting 5 more 5cm long iron rod pieces, which I hammered into the plastic cores, in order to then cover them with lots of copper wire, in order to transform them into 6 electromagnets. Next, I took measurements of my flask in order to create this enclosure in Fusion 360. I think it is quite obvious where the flask will sit, as well as where the magnets will be positioned. But you might be asking yourself what this slot underneath the flask is for. Well, I will be using it to position some addressable LEDs. This way, I can use the individual LEDs in order to also display the strength of the frequency bands in the music in front of the respective magnets. And with that explanation out of the way, I let my 3D printer do the printing while I designed this schematic for the project. An Arduino is of course the heart of the system that controls everything. Then we got an MSGEQ7 IC, which is a 7-band graphic equalizer that will give us the frequency response to our music signal for 7 frequency bands. So simply put, we feed the music signal in here, the MSGEQ7 does its magic, and thus the Arduino knows which frequencies are currently in our music. According to this music, the Arduino then not only controls the addressable LED strip, but also 6 MOSFETs, whose job it is to basically turn on and off our electromagnets. I think if you watched some of my previous videos, then this schematic should be pretty straightforward. So, the next step was to gather all of the required components and solder them to one another according to the schematic onto a piece of perf board. To make the connections, I used solder bridges, silver copper wire, and eventually even some hookup wire, because the design was getting pretty busy and chaotic. And if you're interested in pictures of my finished design and more information about this project, then feel free to have a look in the video description. But anyway, after roughly around 2 hours, the circuit was basically done. And thus, it was time to not only hook up an audio source to it in the form of my smartphone, but also the LED strip. And after then connecting the Arduino to my computer, it was time for programming. But instead of using the MSGEQ7 as well as the LED's datasheet in order to create my own code from scratch, I rather used an existing MSGEQ7 library and the FastLED library. With it, I was able to create this small piece of code, which basically spits out the bass, middle and high frequencies in 8-bit form over the serial monitor, while lighting up the targeted LEDs. By using a frequency generator app, you can not only see that the circuit works on the computer, but you can also see it through the LED's light. Last thing to add to the codes was to turn on the MOSFETs, depending on whether the frequency values are above or below a low and high threshold value. And with that being completed, I turned over to my 3D print, and noticed that I probably should have used some more support material. But nevertheless, after removing the existing supports, the enclosure may not look very appealing, but it surely does its job. So after placing all of the components in its rightful place and connecting the electromagnets to the circuit, it was finally time for a first proper test with the function generator. And yes, it does work. But I think we need some more ferrofluids inside the flask. Luckily, you can get such fluid pretty easily. And thus I added quite a bit more before I started a second test. This time with music. Listen. Now I'm quite pleased with the result of this project, which is much more appealing to look at than by just using permanent magnets. But it is kind of sad that I'm not able to show you how this ferrofluid rocks out to some AC/DC music. So I guess you will have to give this project a try if you want to find out. As always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and maybe support me through Patreon if you enjoy my work and want me to continue producing more videos. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!